Unified Multiaxis Toolpath in Mastercam 2022 can easily replicate the functionality of many existing multiaxis toolpath options in Mastercam. But aside from being a more flexible interface, what sets it apart? Let's look at the biggest single advantage offered by the Unified Toolpath. Traditionally, once a cut pattern has been chosen, it's set in stone for the life of the toolpath. Even with a meticulous approach to tool axis control and collision control, there are times when a change to the very base of the toolpath is necessary. For example, operation 14 shown here is a perfectly functional toolpath, with many parameters set up throughout the interface. If we decide at this point that we aren't happy with these retracts and want to take a different approach, we are out of luck. We can't change this toolpath to a morph toolpath. This is where Unified completely sets itself apart from its peers. In the parameters of operation 15, I can choose to scrap the approach to cut pattern while keeping all other parameters of the toolpath untouched. Instead of the old parallel to a curve approach, let's choose perpendicular. Click Preview Toolpath to see the changes on your screen without closing the toolpath parameters. Here, we still have a completely useful toolpath with a totally different approach. No need to change any other parameters. We can scrap the curve input altogether and let Unified Automatic decide an approach. Because the only boundary edges of the drive surface selection are the same edges that we'd use in a morph toolpath, let's choose Machining Boundary Morph. When we click Preview, we see the results of a traditional morph between two curves toolpath, without having to manually select a single curve. If we decide this automatic cut pattern creates inefficient axis motion, we can instead lock the motion parallel to the front plane. Perhaps as an alternative, we can use a single guide curve as a starting point. Since the toolpath now collapses into these corners, we can add another guide curve to this row to create a blend style toolpath. We can also achieve a similar result by using the same two curves in separate curve input groups set to morph. The advantage to using the guide curve method instead of morph is that the guide curve uses the geodesic toolpath algorithm. This algorithm, formerly known as exact mode, opens up some very powerful new options in submenus, including the ability to fill holes in faces or to trim out small passes. Using the guide curve method, we are also allowed to select more than two input curves. This is something that has never been possible with morph. It doesn't matter if all the guide curves are inside of a single input row or if each curve has its own input row. The toolpath will generate, all while maintaining every single downstream parameter. Even if you have no idea what the best final cut pattern is, you can simply start with Unified and have the flexibility to take the toolpath in an entirely new direction without ever needing to start from scratch. Developing a toolpath from a blank page has never been easier, thanks to this extremely powerful new tool in Mastercam 2022.